Hi there! Welcome po sa akin channel. Ngayon, ang ituturo ko sa inyo ay ang tamang gamit ng lay at lie sa English. Dito, madalas nalilito at nagkakamali sa pagsagot sa quiz ang mga estudyante. Actually, kuminsan pati mga professionals at mga native English speakers ay nalilito din sa tamang gamit nito. Like this example. If you are tired and you want to rest, would you say, I want to lie down or I want to lay down? Now, bago natin sagutin yan, alamin muna natin ang mga kahulugan ng lay at lie. Here, lay means to put an object or something down slowly. Ibig sabihin, ang lay ay ilapag o ilagay sa ibaba ang isang bagay. And then lie naman, sa English, this means to recline or to put your body down in the bed to rest or sleep. Sa Tagalog, ito ay ibig sabihin ay sumandal o humiga, recline sa English. At meron pa tayong isang kahulugan ng lie. Ito naman yung opposite of truth or magsinungaling. Pero ito ay ating i-discuss mamaya later on. Unahin muna natin itong lay. Now, meron tayong four parts of verbs. Yung present tense, present participle, past tense, and the past participle. Now, let us have this first example. Please blank the plates on the table properly. Now, hahanapin natin dito kung ano ang tamang sagot. Now, this is in the present tense, so the answer should be lay. Ito, kasi nasa present tense tayo. Next, she is blank the plates on the table. Alright, ito ay nasa present continuous tense tayo, kaya gagamit tayo ng present participle, laying. Meron tayong is dito. So, it should be, she is laying the plates on the table. Next example, she blanked the plates on the table yesterday. Now, notice here, ang time element natin dito ay yesterday. So, ito ay nakalipas na. So, gagamit tayo ng past tense dito. So, the correct answer should be laid. She laid the plates on the table yesterday. Next, she blanked the plates on the table yesterday when the visitors arrived. Alright, gagamit tayo rito ng past participle. So, it should be has laid. Now, let us remember, lay is a kind of verb which falls under transitive verb. Ito ay palaging transitive verb. Pag sinabi natin transitive verb, yan yung verb na mayroong object. Paano natin malalaman na mayroong object? Katulad nito. My father lays carpet for a living. Now, para malaman natin ang direct object, we should read first the subject and the verb. My father lays what? Kapag may answer sa question of what or who, yung answer ang ating direct object. So here, my father lays what? The answer is carpet. So, carpet ang ating direct object. Ang ating subject ay itong father, and then ang ating verb ay itong lays. Ang lays ay isang transitive verb. So, ang pattern ay STVDO, direct object. Yan ang DO natin. Now, sa next sentence naman, I want to lay what? Again, we're going to ask the question what or who. Ang answer ay baby, this baby. So, ang baby ang ating direct object. Now, dahil meron tayong direct object, itong lay ay transitive verb. Alright, remember that, ang lay ay palaging transitive verb at palaging may object. Katulad nito, my mother laid what? The blanket over me last night. So, ang blanket ang direct object. So, ang lay dito ay transitive verb. Remember, kapag walang object, ibig sabihin, ang verb ay intransitive verb. Okay. At ito ay nangyayari lang dito sa lie. Ito ay intransitive verb. Wala itong direct object. Okay. Next example. The president laid the rules during the meeting. Now, again, we are going to ask the question what? The president laid what? The answer is rules. So, rules ang ating direct object. So, ang laid dito ay tama. Kasi, it is a transitive verb. Alright. Next. Sa lie naman. Now, lie means to recline. Dito tayo sa recline na nakasandal o kahiga. Now, again, we have the present tense, present participle, past tense, and past participle. Dito, ang present participle ay lying. And past tense is lay. And the past participle is has or have lain. Okay. Now, let us start with this example. The dog blank on the floor. Dito, nasa present tense tayo. So, dito, the dog lies on the floor. Notice, nagkaroon tayo rito ng S kasi ang ating subject ay singular. Nasa third person singular tayo. Present tense, kaya nagkaroon tayo rin ng S. Alright, next. This document has been blank on the floor the whole day. Now, notice here, pag tayo ay nagtanong, the document has been what? Wala ritong direct object. Unlike dun sa lay kangina, meron tayong direct object. Dito, wala. Dito, the dog lies. Wala rin direct object dito. Ang on the floor ay hindi direct object kasi ito ay prepositional phrase. Okay. Dito, hindi rin ito. Next example, I was not feeling so well. So, I blank on my bed and sleep the whole afternoon. Now, notice again, ang sabi ka nito sa verb phrase natin ay itong I blank on my bed and sleep. Notice itong sleep ay past tense. So, dito, gagamit tayo dito ng past tense. So, the correct answer should be lay. I was not feeling well, so I lay on my bed and sleep the whole afternoon. So, ito ay based dito sa present tense na lie. Ang past tense ay lay. Okay. Next example, the lion has blank on the ground silently, waiting for its prey to come closer. Now, tayo ng past participle, kasi meron tayong has. The lion has lain on the ground silently, waiting for its prey to come closer. Okay. So, dito, ang past participle ng lie ay lain. Okay, huwag nating gagamitin ang laid kasi ang laid ay para yan sa lay. Again, dito, wala tayong direct object dito. The lion has lain what? Walang answer. So, there is no direct object. So, ang lain dito ay tama. Now, another explanation for lie. As I've said, this is under intransitive verb. Pag sinabi natin intransitive verb, there is no direct object. So, if you are going to ask the question, what? The dog lies what? There is no answer. So, since there is no answer, there is no direct object. At remember, pag lie, it is intransitive verb, walang direct object dito. So, tama dito ang lies. Next example, this document has been lying on the floor the whole day. Again, if you are going to ask the question, what? That this document has been lying what? Oh, wala ring answer. So, walang direct object dito. Again, sumusunod tayo rito sa ating definition ng lie as an intransitive verb. Wala ritong direct object. Okay. Next, the lion has lain on the ground silently, waiting for its prey to come closer. Again, if you're going to ask the question, what? The lion has slain what? Wala ring answer. So, this is intransitive verb. Now, notice here, dito, para malaman natin na tama ang ating sagot, itong lies, papalitan natin ng just mentally replace lies with the verb be or is, are, was, or were. Kapag hindi na bago ang sense sa sentence, then our answer is correct. Say for example, the dog is on the floor. Nothing is changed. So, ang lies dito ay tama. Next, this document was on the floor the whole day. So, wala rin na bago. So, ang lying dito ay tama. Next, I was not feeling well. So, I was on my bed. Oh, mentally replace lay with was. At tingnan natin kung may nabago. Walang nabago. So, ang lay ay tama. And then here, the lion has lain on the ground silently, waiting for its prey to come closer. If I'm going to replace this with the verb be, say for example, the lion was on the ground. Oh, nothing is changed. So, ang lane natin dito ay tama. Remember, lahat ng answer natin dito ay based dito sa verb na lie. Now, we're going to go back dito sa una nating mga example dito. Ang trick naman dito, let us just mentally replace lay with the verb put. Pag hindi na bago ang sense sa sentence, our answer is correct. Say for example, please put the plates on the table properly. Oh, well, nothing is changed. Walang nabago. So, ang lay ay tama. Next. She put the plates on the table. Nothing is changed. So, ang laying dito ay tama rin. Next. She laid the plates on the table yesterday. She put the plates on the table yesterday. Nothing is changed pa rin. So, ang laid ay tama pa rin. And then here. She put the plates on the table yesterday when the visitors arrived. So, nothing is changed also. So, remember, ang trick dito sa lay, yes, I just mentally replace it with the verb put. Pag walang nabago sa sense na sentence, our answer is correct. Pag nabago, ibig sabihin ito ay mali at ang tamang answer ay lie. Okay, let us proceed to the next. Now, lie naman sa na ibig sabihin ay not to tell the truth or magsinungaling. Ang present tense nito ay lie na katulad nitong sa recline. Ang present participle ay lying katulad din dito sa lie na recline. But the past tense is lied. Hindi na lay. Ito na pa kaibayan ng lied. And then sa past participle, I lied rin. Has or have lied. Say for example, do not lie with your age during the interview. Okay. Again, as I've said, ang ibig sabihin ng lie ay not telling the truth o magsinungaling. Huwag magsinungaling sa iyong edad sa panahon ng interview. Next example, somebody lied during the public meeting yesterday. Alright. Again, dito, ang ibig sabihin ng lie, based sa context dito sa sentence, ay ito ay nagsinungaling. Somebody lied during the public meeting yesterday. Mayroong nagsinungaling sa public meeting kahapon. Next, he was caught lying with his educational background during the interview. Okay? Dito, ang lying ay pagsisinungaling pa rin. So, madali nating makuha ito ang answer dito based sa context basta hindi nagsasabi ng totoo. Okay. Now, another one is lie as opposite of truth as noun. Itong unang nating lie dito, ito ay verb. Okay, verb ito rito. Next naman, lie as opposite of truth as a noun. Example, I can't believe you would say that. That's a lie. Alright. Ang lie dito ay hindi na verb. Noun na siya. Another example, liars are fond of telling lies. Okay. Lies ay noun na naman dito. Now, let us go back to our question. If you are tired and you want to rest, would you say, I want to lie down or I want to lay down? Alright, let us analyze carefully this one. I want to lie down. Tingnan natin kung meron ditong direct object. I want to lie what? Anong ihiga niya? Wala namang sinabi. So, walang direct object. So, ang lie dito ang tama. Dito sa isa, I want to lie what? Wala namang sinabi rito. So, ang lay dito ay mali. Dito ang tama. So, ang correct answer natin ay, I want to lie down. Kasi wala tayong direct object. At, another one. Para malaman natin ang tamang sagot dito, just mentally replace lie with the verb be or is, was, were, is, are, was, or were. Now, dito, papalitan natin ito, nang be. I want to be down. Nothing is changed. So, ang lie dito ay tama. Dito naman, kung ang lie ang gagawin natin dito, dapat ito ay meron siyang direct object. Dapat ganito. I want to lay my body down. Ang body ang direct object. So, tama rito ang lie. kung li ang gagamitin natin dito. Kaya lang dito, wala siyang direct object, kaya mali ang lay dito. Ang tama ay itong I want to lie down. Alright, another. Remember, kung lay ang answer natin, ay dapat merong direct object katulad nito. Ibig sabihin, is going to put his body down. Yan. Remember, ang ibig sabihin ng lay ay to put something down. Maglapag o maglagay sa ibaba ng isang bagay. Okay. Now, let us have a short quiz. And then, let us see if you can give the correct answers. We are going to pause this video for a while. We are going to check your answer. Alright, let us now check your answer. Number one, I want you to lie down next to me while watching the show. The correct answer is lie. Kasi wala ditong direct object. And another thing, para malaman natin kung tama itong lie, papalitan natin ito ng verb na be. Kung hindi na bago ang pag hindi na bago ang thought sa sentence, then tama ang lie. Example, I want you to be down next to me. Walang nabago. So lie is correct. Next, whenever she is tired, she used to lie. Tama ang correct answer ay lie down on her back. Again, wala rin itong kasunod na direct object. So, lie ang tamang sagot. At another, maging sure tayo na ito ay tama, we are going to mentally replace this with the verb be. Whenever she is tired, she used to be down on her back. Okay, nothing is changed. So, lie is, here is correct. Next, just lay those reports on my table and you can go. Alright. Here we are going to ask the question what? Just lay what? The answer is those reports. So, those reports ang ating direct object. So, ang lay ay tama kasi meron siyang direct object. And another thing, para masiguro natin, just mentally replace lay with put. Example, just put those reports on my table and you can go. Nothing is changed. So, lay is correct. Another, number four. She loves to lie on the beach during the weekends. So, lie ang ating answer dito kasi wala ritong direct object. Walang direct object. And another thing, kung papalitan natin ito ng verb na be, nothing should be changed. So, for example, she loves to be on the beach during weekends. So, nothing is changed. So, lie here is correct. And then, last one, Brenda wants to lie on the rocking chair and finish reading her book. Lie is our answer here kasi wala rin itong direct object. And, kung papalitan natin ito ng verb na be, nothing should be changed. Like this one, Brenda wants to be on the rocking chair and finish reading her book. Or nothing is changed. So, lie here is correct. Now, if you have learned something in this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, click the notification bell in order to be updated, and of course, please share also. Thank you very much for watching. See you again.